The dramatic narratives of the geologic past are perfectly suited to the human appetite for storytelling. Like many who experienced childhood or parenthood in the last 50 years, I love Maurice Sendak's Where the Wild Things Are. It's a book about the power of imagination to take us to other worlds, transcend time, and save us from our worst selves. I think of Max's Voyage whenever I teach History of Earth and Life, a course in which we cover Earth's 4.5 billion year history in a 10-week term at an average clip of about 450 million years a week. I always feel that I've been on a long journey with my students. We've witnessed alien Earths, explored alternate ecosystems teeming with strange wild things through bountiful times and bad ones. Finally, we approach the present and see the modern world emerging from the mists, just as Max's room gradually sheds its vines and becomes recognizable again. I believe, perhaps naively, that if more people could experience this journey and see themselves as earthlings with a common past and shared destiny, it might spring us out of our polarized and entrenched ways of thinking about the world. As a geologist, I've worked with people from all over the world, from very different cultures and generations older and younger than mine. The strong human connections I've developed with them through our shared study of Earth make me optimistic that a geocentric, timeful worldview might help us overcome the animosities and barriers that divide us and get down to work on things that really matter. Collective awareness of Earth's story might save us from environmental hubris. Understanding how historical happenstance is written into each of our personal lives might cause us to treat each other with more empathy. And a timeful habit of mind might even make us less neurotic about the fact of our own mortality by shifting our focus from the finite lengths of our lives to the rich anthology of experiences that a lifetime represents. While other senses may be dulled with age, the sense of time, which can only be developed by experiencing it, is heightened. Growing old requires one to shed the illusion that there's only one version of the world.